This edition of the Ridley Report is brought to you by LRN.FM. Feds don't want you to hear them.
Mr. Rook, a question for you. Are homeschoolers being allowed access to Bronstein Park during school hours?
Are you satisfied that all the closed meetings are following the law? What would you say is the difference between taxing someone for a school and stealing from them? And why aren't you talking to New Hampshire's number two YouTube channel? Mayor, are homeschoolers allowed in Bronstein Park during school hours? I can't think of anything else to ask you, but I will later. Okay, so Mayor Gatsis is entering the meeting from a secret passage. Guess he doesn't feel comfortable standing there and saying nothing when I ask questions. Well, to what extent, if I may ask, are homeschoolers allowed at Bronstein Park? Now there's Erica Connors also entering from one of the Medici-style government-only entrances. I think it was the autocrat Lorenzo de' Medici in Florence who established for the first time maybe that Renaissance process of creating a way that the ruler could move around without ever being interacted with by the people.
I should clarify a bit. What made Lorenzo de' Medici special was that he used architecture in ingenious ways to keep him from having to interact with the people.
So, I guess the school attendees are welcome in the mayor's office, but not the Ridley.
Always must tax recipients have priority over taxpayers.
Gotta give credit to the security guard, though. He used to give me grief for filming, and he's not doing that yet today.
Ms. Dumpy?
Yes.
You're running for Senate, right?
Yes, I am.
Question for you. There are oftentimes conflicts between the state and federal governments. Where would you say your loyalties lie?
The state.
With the state?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that was a straight answer.
Local. Obviously local.
All right. Thanks much. See you out there. Mayor, is there a reason why you guys can't just sell Bronstein Park and give the money back to taxpayers instead of having all this brouhaha over how it should be treated? Did you really cast the deciding vote, Mayor, to give the welfare commissioner an increase in salary, a massive increase in salary, when he's got a deficit that he's just announced, supposedly, of what, $300,000? Mr. Ryan, did you really tell the board, well, I'll ask you later. Did Mr.
Well,
no, I don't want to do that. Did Mr. Ryan actually tell you guys that you had to vote on his curriculum before reading it, or in order to read it? Oh, okay. What did he say? I mean, I heard otherwise on the Gerard show.
LRN.FM, 24 hours of Liberty Radio every day. Now available on satellite, too.
at sat.lrn.fm. That's what a satellite sounds like. Put it on your unlicensed station. Wear it in your hair. But above all, don't despair. The Liberty message is getting out. And right now, you're missing it. Or maybe you're not. But skip on over to
lrn.fm. Feds don't want you to hear them.